New suit, yeah, big boss. I'm knowing I ain't hearing out of young thing. Double back twice in a row, 3 drinks.
Hey, everybody, we're coming to you live on 2K Sports, bringing you the NBA. Hi, folks, this is, well, when we look at tonight, this could come down to the backcourts, Grant. They're both very talented.
Yeah, B.A., you know I love great guard play. And, of course, each team has some serious skills at that position. So expect a fast pace of play, lots of threes. It should be one heck of a matchup.
So the Hornets starting five. Paul and Rozier are the guards. Nick Richards out there with Washington. And it's Oubre at the small forward position.
That's a pretty easy opportunity for a teammate, all courtesy of Harrison Barnes.
Pass the ball. Washington, a screen on Fox. Ball passes to Washington. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
The defensive effort was lacking a bit, but hey, give them credit for finding a weakness there.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive score.
Always fun to see point guards who can elevate above the rim like that.
Oh, a strong mindset and even stronger finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting.
Tons of hype around LaMelo Ball, the third overall pick in 2020. Just like you, Grant.
Yeah, although the draft was a little different back in my day. But let me tell you, B.A., there was so much pressure being a top three pick. It's really impressive that LaMelo has lived up to the lofty expectations.
Oubre passes the ball. Now Washington. From deep. Shot. Rebounded by Lyles. And in the first, a little over a minute and a half in. Fox for three. DiVincenzo. Great positioning on the putback.
DiVincenzo getting those feet together, and Dante does the rest.
The Hornets have gone just 2 for 4 from the floor. Pass to Richards. Oubre with it. Richards with a screen. And jams it home with authority.
Just great offense. The screen freeing him up for the slam.
Hey, without that screen, he doesn't get a clean look at the rim.
Yeah, well, how do you settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that? Not just accuracy in the quarter, it's his movement and the energy that's getting him on this nice roll.
The three for ball. Kings have gone 4 of 6 in the first quarter. Fox outside. From the arc. Another three for Sacramento.
And he's carried them this quarter. A dominant offensive stretch.
Charlotte's gone 0-for-3 from downtown. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Rozier with it. He's picked up by Barnes. Fires from deep. They get it back. Here's Richards. That one falls.
A stronger defensive presence would have saved them 2 points.
It didn't seem like anybody was really aware there to go collect that rebound.
And the Kings going with a whole new group out there. So Charlotte going with almost an entire new group here. Mark has checked in for Richards. Gordon Hayward comes in for Oubre. Martin, he's checked in for Rozier. And Wright subbed in for LaMelo Ball.
I just love the strong finish there inside.
Man, he's got that dunker's mindset, doesn't he? Always ready to pounce.
Well, one thing the Kings got when they hired Mike Brown is a coach who's been through and seen it all. He's a coaching experience. Leaping ability is off the charts. Not the biggest power forward, but outstanding at rising up off the ground.
Knock loose. First quarter of play, and just over 3.5 minutes in, fires the three. It doesn't go for it, so the Kings will take it the other way. When it comes to Mike Brown, he's been an assistant or a head coach for 6 different teams now.
That's a different kitchens to be in, B.A., and as an assistant, he's worked for great coaches, Greg Popovich, Steve Kerr, Rick Carlisle. A great group of coaches to draw upon, and then add his own styles in. And what he wants to do with this Kings team moving forward.
And that's as good a look as he's going to get. He's just got to shake that one off and keep it moving.
Pass to Lynn. Here's Suggs. Puts up a three. Washington grabs. a miss. Martin outside. Now Hayward. Here's Wright. That one's good. And it's Hayward with the setup.
And when Hayward has the ball, he watches all the angles. That's how he finds wide open guys to feed.
On the wing, Suggs. Here's the three. Sinks it from distance. Suggs has got five.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. Four of the last five buckets have been thrown.
And there's the foul. It'll go on Terrence Davis. That's his first foul of the game.
First team foul.
Understanding the space that he can cover is a big
credit their discipline. They've been working for high percentage shots.
And Mitchell puts up a deep three. And no good. Trying to get that one forward. And so it's De'Aaron Fox making highlights for Sacramento. He put together 10 points in the quarter and more NBA action.
Fans, please give a big round of applause for your king.
Tuning in and just joining us. We played through one quarter of action so far. And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Sacramento.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
Well, I want to add also the damage that has been done on the inside. A lot of rubber in there, but they're continuing to go right at the defense.
On the court for Charlotte, Ball and Rozier are the guards. Then there's Kelly Oubre. Then there's Nick Richards. And it's Clark in at the four. And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
Yeah, taking the onus on himself to make something happen. Got it into the teeth of the defense and made them pay.
Fox against Ball. Down to five on the shot clock. Can't cash in the 10-footer.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
We know Fox is at his best. He's playing with the pace, Brett.
Yeah, he can pass and defend, but it's that speed that really tips the scales as to how much of an effect he's going to have in winning basketball games. That three-point shot comes around. It's a bit more consistent, but a whole other level in Fox game.
Fox for three. Nails it. He's now 6-for-8 for the floor.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
Well, the Hornets shooting around 44%. Not bad. Outside Oubre. To the middle. Here's Richards. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Richards has got his third basket on the night right there.
Oubre will draw some attention as a scorer, but that's going to open up some passing lanes. Doesn't make a mistake that time.
Basket unprotected. Bad things will happen to you.
Yeah, that was just way too easy.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
Clark, no good.
Looks like the game plan is they're willing to give him that kind of shot. It worked out for them this time, but they give it to him again. I bet 3 points are coming.
Like a matador. Olay!
There was no defense. That has to be one of the easier shots I've seen tonight.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
So the Kings making a change here. Holmes has checked in. All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
Well, guys, with the yearly roster moves, it might be hard for the casual fan to keep track. But Commissioner Silver said it's a necessary side effect. He said, quote, we try to tie performance to pay in a closer way. And I think that's what you see with shorter contracts. Brian, more player movement has been the result.
He has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Ball passes to Rozier. Richards with a screen. Ball against Fox. Deep corner Rozier. Yes, sir. And it's Ball with the assist that time.
4-3.
Ball's got three assists now in this one. And here in the middle of the season, these teams really coming into their own right now. They found their identity and know what they're all about, Grant.
Well, oftentimes that's what happens. I mean, these guys have had the time to gel and get to know how they like to play. And at
just executed. For three, DiVincenzo gets the three ball to go. DiVincenzo's got 5 points.
And a quick release from Dante there just in time so the defense had no shot.
What a timeout called by Charlotte. This is the first they're seeing of Sacramento.
Yeah, they had some trouble with this team last year. It's winning the season series.
And a new group getting ready for the Kings. Lenz checked in for Holmes. Davis comes in for Lyles. Suggs is checked in for DiVincenzo. And Mitchell subbed in for De'Aaron Fox. So Charlotte going with almost an entire new group here. Washington's checked in for Richards. Gordon Hayward comes in for Clark. Clark, he's checked in for Oubre. And Wright subbed in for Ball. Suggs with the bucket.
And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
Charlotte's gone 1-4 from three-point land here in the second. It's clear Charlotte has the pieces in place to make noise in the league for years to come.
Yeah, no question, B.A. They got one of the best young rosters in the NBA. And they're balanced. They play tremendous team basketball. Fun to watch.
On the wing, Suggs. For three.
And the Kings with another three. Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
Rozier outside. Will it go? Does it go for him? Now Sacramento takes it the other way. Fresh off a win against the Pacers.
What about their offense? It was a well-oiled machine. Getting them high-quality looks time and time again.
And talking with the coaching staff, they said in that game, they did a great job of not settling. Keep working the ball around, finding the best look. Let's see if they can keep that up.
Rozier with it. And Davis picks him up defensively. Outside for Rozier.
They look frustrated right now. Nothing seems to be falling, and it's starting to get to them.
Here's Suggs. And the basket is good. Suggs has got 8 points in the quarter.
A steady start has turned into a spectacular second quarter for him.
Up top, Rozier. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Clippers.
Rozier, such a fantastic score. A gear-shifting, talented goal. Continues to improve.
Terry Rozier taking two shots.
Both free throws good from Rozier. 17 seconds left in the first half. Mitchell, pass to Davis. On the wing, Suggs.
Putting on a clinic.
I'm shocked. I can't believe he pulled that off in a real game. And so it's Sacramento. A huge 24-point lead for them. And their defense has stood out, wreaking havoc for the opposition. More 2K action in just a moment.
Evening, folks. This first half is like a highlight reel for De'Aaron Fox.
He's hitting all the buckets. When you got a guy this hot, just gotta let him do his thing.
Yeah, no question. His thing is working, running wild. And now, let's take a second here to look at what's ahead on the schedule.
And for that matchup with the Timberwolves, they should be considered the favorite.
That's it for halftime. Thank you for...
Second half here. A big comeback is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Boy, it's been one outstanding game from De'Aaron Fox.
Through the first two quarters and change, his perimeter shooting continues to be spot on.
Yeah, you would hope the defense at least would start to consider creeping up on him just a little bit.
Dante DiVincenzo out there with De'Aaron Fox. Then it's Trey Lyles. Then there's Barnes, and it's Holmes, in at the five, roaming the paint. That's the group starting the second half for Mike Brown. Pass to Oubre, lets the three fly. Rebound by the Kings.
And you have to think that they're leading this game because of how they've controlled the boards tonight.
The three, DiVincenzo, and the Kings with another three.
They've been very well-rounded and extremely focused.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight. You know, guys, they say speed kills. And in this case, it kills defense. Fox just so quick with the ball.
Richards with a screen. Ball outside. 4-3. He drops it from range. Ball's gotten himself going with a triple. His first basket of the game.
And both teams running long-range plays that are working.
Both of them looking towards the three-point line. I like to see that, especially when the results are big buckets.
And with that quickness, Fox is so difficult for defenses to contain.
Yeah, the one thing, B.A., that I love is when De'Aaron picks a tough angle to match up against, because guys tracking him, they're going to lose a little bit of steam. And when he gets ahead, it's a great decision to make.
Now a timeout by Sacramento. Mark has checked in for Charlotte. With a break here, let's see which team racked up the assists during last year's campaign. Number one, the Hornets.
It was a joy to watch these guys play. Constant ball movement and player movement. Defenses were worn out by the end of games.
The Kings have gone 3 of 3 in the second half. Pass to DiVincenzo. Yes! And a nice assist for Fox.
The assist?
Fox has got 5 assists in the game. For Charlotte, they've got 2 of 4 shots to go since the break. Rozier with it. Ooh, a two-handed power slam!
He's got a big speed advantage in that matchup. Could be a blow-by every single time.
Right side, DiVincenzo. And the Kings with another three!
Yeah, he's been having his way this quarter. Attacking the basket and protecting their lead.
Richards with a screen. Outside for Rozier. Let's go with a three. No good. And the Kings going the other way now.
You have to credit their effort. I mean, they've done an amazing job on the glass.
You know, guys, there's one thing that may have hurt the Hornets the past few seasons. A lack of playoff experience among their core players.
Pass to Richards. And here's Ball. Back to Richards. And Holmes pulls it down. And of the Hornets' top 5 scorers last season, 3 have never been to the playoffs.
And B.A., that can be tough when the pressure's on. They've gotten blown out in play-in games each of the last 2 seasons. But with all their talent, they should be in the postseason soon enough.
Rozier from outside. Rebounded by Fox. Fox has got his 4th rebound in this one. For 3, DiVincenzo. That's it. Coming off an assist from Barnes. Barnes has got his 4th assist with that last one.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
They're pretty infectious right here, guys. In good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Holmes down low, pounded by Ball. And it's Fox missing. Charlotte has gone 1 of 4 here in the third from range. And De'Aaron Fox picks up the foul. That's his first foul. So it's both teams making substitutions here.
Substituting on the court.
1:16 left in the third quarter. Ball outside to halt the run. Sacramento grabs the miss.
The other team just looks more in sync and is riding the momentum.
Well, the other team is scorching hot, and they come down on this end and can't find a way to get the embers going.
Pass to Oubre. Ball with it. 44 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Richards inside. He's covered by Fox. A nice shot by Richards.
Hard work on the offensive glass. You can see the coaching staff rise up and clap for that effort.
For 3, DiVincenzo. Counted from distance. DiVincenzo's got 30.
When this guy starts hitting 3s, watch out. He's just pouring it on his half.
Pass to Richards. 6-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. The kick out to Ball. The 3. Called in by DiVincenzo.
Maybe a time to rest him right now. Just give him a bit of a breather. Try to help him get back on track.
Outside Davis. 3-pointer, Fox. Oh, it Dante DiVincenzo making things happen for the Kings. Keep paying.
Please give a big round of applause.
And while we have a chance, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
He's always near the top of the list for this honor. I mean, passes like these are his specialty.
Doesn't happen with every point guard in the league as far as setting your teammates up. Lots more scorers now, but right there creating the scoring opportunity for his teammate.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. You know, for most players, being a starter has value. But Grant, some elite teams have been elevated by great players who have accepted a reserve role.
And it's really special, BA, when you have that. Players who are willing to sacrifice for the greater good of the team. Putting winning first at all costs. When you think about it, through the years, Manu Ginobili with the Spurs, Andre Iguodala and Golden State, it really can galvanize a team and lead to a winning championship.
On the court for the Hornets. They've got Jalen McDaniels. DeLon Wright is out there with Booknight. And it's Monroe into the five. Suggs, no good.
For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Pass to Booknight. This one for three. Charlotte again missing. About 1 minute played here in the fourth quarter. The three from Suggs. The Hornets pull it in. Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Right outside. Back to Jones. Uses the glass on the layup.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Yeah, they have a long way to go, but attacking the rim like that is a great way to start a comeback. An aggressive move, takes it strong, and there's no help defensively.
Here's Booknight, checked by Davis. Here's the floater. Outside McDaniels. The offensive rebound. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
And this is something he does all too well. Great position for the putback there.
And I like how he doesn't think twice about passing it out. Just going right for the slam.
Well, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
Pass to Monroe. Throws it hard with one hand. Wow, he makes it look easy.
B.A., the one-hand dunk just looks so fluid.
Man, absolutely. Even smooth when he's powering it home like that. Suggs, no good.
He is terrific shooting the ball in the first half, but he looks a little bit slower out there. Possibly leg tired here in the second half.
I mean, he's trying to shoot his way out of what's becoming a prolonged cold streak.
Yeah, he's got to move on, forget about this sequence here, and try to find a way to get on the board.
The Hornets have gotten just 3 of 9 shots to go in, struggling this fourth quarter. Right outside, pass to Monroe.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
1:58 left in the game. McDaniels from long range. Patton pulls it in. Sacramento has got nothing to fall from outside the arc here in the fourth. 0-for-4. Harkless shot is good.
That's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Now here's McDaniels. Beyond the arc. And once again, off the mark by Charlotte. Here's Davis. Oh, touch off the glass.
And you can see how scary this team can be when everything is clicking for them. Just a terrific performance for the Kings.
And everything seemed to go their way today. They were firing on all cylinders, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., this was the kind of performance you relish as a player. Just a very impressive win.
And with this one, they go double digits in the win column. On the wing, Davis. The three from Suggs. Gets rebounded by Charlotte. There's 57 seconds left to play in the fourth. Right. Patton pulls it in.
That's going up against a defense that knows your tendencies.
Pass to Harkless. Here's Suggs, pounded by Wright. The three is up. Offensive rebound, Kings. Here's Suggs, launches a three. Jones grabs the board.
Boy, I'd love to see him just get a smidge closer to the basket. Once he sees a few shots go in from there, that might open up everything from distance.
Booknight can't get it to go.
Something's off about him this quarter.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
King's foul. Jalen Suggs. First personal foul. First team foul. Substituting on the court.
And I'm sure their fans appreciated it too. We saw the outstanding defense and loaded offensive effort. They were just dominant out there.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. Now it's time for the New Balance Player of the Game, Dante.
To that theory. Every day I battle, I'm exhausted and I'm weary. Make sure I smile in public when alone, my eyes teary. I fought through.